After more than 4 years of frustrating delays, Blue Origin is finally making significant progress toward completing development of its powerful Be-4 rocket engine. At present, engineers and technicians with the company are assembling the first two flight engines at Blue Origin's main factory in Kent, Washington. The company aspires to deliver these two flight engines to United Launch Alliance before the end of this year, although that increasingly appears to be a stretch goal. Delivery may slip into early 2023. And in order to make this deadline, Blue Origin plans to take the somewhat risky step of shipping the engines to its customer before completing full qualification testing. This delivery has been a long time coming. United Launch Alliance, or ULA, first agreed to buy the engines from Blue Origin back in 2014. It was a bold bet by ULA, a blue blood in space launch, on a new entrant to the market. But with the Be-4 engine, Blue Origin founder Jeff Bezos was promising a relatively low-cost, high-performing engine with a power output comparable to a space shuttle main engine. At the time of this initial agreement, Blue Origin said the Be-4 would be ready for flight by 2017. The Be-4's delayed development has, increasingly, been the subject of keen interest. This is partly because ULA has been working on its new Vulcan rocket for a number of years, and that rocket is important to the future of the company. The military is also eager for this delivery, as ULA is a primary provider of launch services to the Department of Defense alongside SpaceX. They hope Vulcan provides lower-cost launch services with engines manufactured in the United States. Finally, many in the space community are genuinely curious about the cause of the delay. Despite this widespread interest, however, Blue Origin has said almost nothing publicly about the engine development. Therefore, this story attempts to provide some context for why the Be-4 engines are late. It is based on anonymous sources at the company's headquarters, as well as industry officials, some of whom would likely be fired if they were named. According to many sources, Blue Origin is unlikely to deliver two flight-ready versions of the Be-4 rocket engine to United Launch Alliance before at least the second quarter of 2022. This increases the possibility that the debut flight of LA's much-anticipated new rocket Vulcan could slip into 2023 Vulcan's first stage is powered by two Be-4 engines, which burn methane and are more powerful than the space shuttle's main engines. Sources say there recently was a relatively small production issue with the fabrication of the flight engines at Blue Origin's factory in Kent, Washington. As a result, the engines will not be completed and shipped to the company's test stands in West Texas until next year. Once there, each engine must be unpacked, tested and then reconfigured to move to LA Rocket Assembly Facility in northern Alabama, a reasonable no earlier than date for the engines. Arrival at the rocket manufacturer is now April of 2022, and this assumes a smooth final production and testing phase. But as we all know, manufacturing engines is very difficult and would require a lot of investment. Even though SpaceX is now in a Raptor engine crisis, Jeff Bezos still has a lot of work to catch up on. This is truly a dire situation, and how did LA react to this continuous delay? What was Tony Bruno's plan and how will it change you? ULA declined to comment on specifics about the production issue. People had often seen that Tony Bruno always covered for Jeff at many previous delays. However, the company now said it was disappointed that it did not receive these two flight engines in 2022. As anticipated, we are disappointed that we will not be receiving Vulcan flight engines from Blue Origin by the end of the year. But they will be arriving early next year, the company said in a statement. The certification program is moving along very well, and the production engines are being manufactured. We look forward to Vulcan's first launch in 2022. However, it now seems far from certain that Vulcan will make its debut in 2022, and there is a lot riding on this rocket and its timely debut, which will replace both the Atlas and Delta rockets that ULA has flown. The U.S. military is counting on Vulcan to lift about 60% of the nation's national security payloads into space from 2022 to 2027 At one point the Vulcan rocket was expected to debut in 2020, the U.S. Space Force and ULA have already agreed to move the first military mission, assigned to Vulcan-designated USF-51 onto an Atlas V rocket. However, LA has since said that all of its remaining Atlas rockets, which are being phased out due to reliance on the Russian-built Rode 180 engine, are allocated to other missions. Therefore, it's not clear that other military missions can be moved off of Vulcan and onto an Atlas, assuming the Be-4 engines arrive at UCLA in April. The company would have about 8 months to prepare the rocket for a test flight in 2022, which will carry a small lunar lander built by a private company, Astrobotic. This is the first time that ULA, which was formed out of the launch divisions of Boeing and Lockheed Martin in 2005, has taken delivery of a brand new first stage rocket. Engine is part of booster development. However, when Boeing and Lockheed first used the RS-68 and RD-180 engines for their Delta and Atlas rockets, it took an average of 19 and a half months from engine delivery to first flight. Vulcan is not expected to require this much time to incorporate the Be-4 rocket engine. However, during our reporters' roundtable in December of 2020, ULA Chief Executive Tory Bruno explained why. In a response, turns out a LA can't wait for Blue Origin. Earlier that year, ULA had taken delivery of Pathfinder engines, which are nearly identical to the flight engines, but not designed to be ignited. But, what is the value of a Pathfinder and cannula improve the launch time? Bruno said these Pathfinder engines have allowed ULA to do a lot of the work that is involved in preparing a rocket for launch in terms of assembling the propulsion end of the booster, sending it to the launch site, and ensuring that it links up with the ground systems there for fueling and other operations. These are really big, heavy, complicated pieces of machinery, Bruno said, so they have custom tooling that handles them in the factory and aligns them and helps us to install them in the rocket. We don't really like to ad-lib anything in our rocket factory, so every move that is made is in a process instruction that has been proved, certified, and then locked down in configuration. What we're doing in this initial pass-through that I call pathfinding, it's making sure that all of that is exactly perfect. Over the last year or so, ULA has used the Pathfinder engines to test the vehicle assembly process, move it into the transport ship, travel to Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida, transferred onto the mobile launch platform, and test ground systems. As a result, Bruno said the 19-and-a-half-month yardstick from the earlier Atlas and Delta development programs is not comparable. All these pre-launch activities were part of that big span that you looked back on, and we are able to work off almost all of that with these Pathfinder engines, right up to just literally short of the flight readiness firing, and then at the last minute, we're able to bring in the flight engines, take them through that whole evolution that has already been a trailblazer for them, and so that's why you don't need them as early. But whether Blue Origin will continue to delay the launch date still makes their partner think twice. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching, and goodbye.